And now for today's Bible question. Today we have learned about the transfiguration of Jesus, about the need for and power of prayer, and preventing offenses when we can. Someone might ask the question, why did only Peter, James, and John have the privilege to see the Lord transfigured? The Lord Jesus had many followers, but he chose just 12 to be his closest companions and servants. These men were given special privilege, but also important responsibilities to carry the message of salvation to the world after Jesus ascended back to heaven. Even among these 12 men, there were three men, Peter, James, and John, that often were with the Lord Jesus on special occasions, such as the Transfiguration, the raising of Jairus' daughter, and praying in the Garden of Gethsemane. These three men were among the first he called to be his disciples, and he wanted them in particular to be a witness for these special occasions. These three men would play a significant role in the early church leadership and witnessing to the resurrection of Christ. Therefore, they needed especially to be taught and strengthened through these special events they were called to witness. Peter would later write about the experience of hearing God speak to them on the mountain and having seen the glory of the Lord. Undoubtedly, this experience enriched Peter's appreciation of the greatness of Christ and his work for all of mankind. This strengthened him in faith to be able to stand against all the opposition he would have to face. John wrote about the power of Christ to raise from the dead. When he wrote a detailed account of the raising of Lazarus from the tomb after he had been dead for 4 days, he had more than once seen his master raise someone from the dead and could testify clearly that he was the way, the truth, and the life. These three men were given unique privileges because of the important roles they would play in testifying about Jesus after his resurrection. It is also true that some are privileged to come near to the Lord and gain a special insight into his glory. This privilege belongs to those whose hearts are sincere in their love and devotion to God. Moses was a man who desired to see the glory of God and was granted the privilege to see something of his glory. The Lord may allow you and I also to draw near and get a glimpse of his glory if that is the sincere desire of our hearts and we walk before him in a manner that is pleasing to him. He is not obligated to reveal himself to those who do not value and appreciate the exalted privilege of drawing near to him. The Lord has his intimates chosen to behold him so that they can declare his glory to a needy world. Maybe you would like to behold the glory of God, but are you ready to suffer to make Christ known to a world that rejects him? When we are willing to join with him in suffering, then we are promised the privilege of sharing in his glory. The scripture says, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. Romans chapter 8, verse 17.